Good day, everybody. Time for the tropical update with J7409. The name you know, the news you can use. So, we've been watching this little system right down here trying to come up, right? Well, this, of course, is the GEFS model, and it's courtesy of Tropical Tidbits. We're going to be looking at more models this morning, though. First, we will turn it on right quickly, and you will see what's going on. But I want to stress that I'm going to give this system about a 45 to 50% chance of turning into a tropical depression, at least. Maybe a tropical storm. And I'll show you why I'm saying that in a moment. But what does the official forecast for this system look like according to all of the models? Well, it seems the primary forecast issues will be details of the northern stream cyclonic flow aloft and effect on the surface fronts and waves and the lower latitude guidance signals for a possible tropical feature. Yes, they say there could be a possible tropical feature to emerge from the northwestern Caribbean. Now, both have been fairly low confidence so far. Regarding the latter, there is a dramatic amount of spreading, and I'll show you that, regarding timing, track, and strength. Now, the GEFS, which you're looking at now, and the GEFS members, which I'll show you also, have tended to be on the faster side of the full envelope, with the midnight running of the GEFS slowing down to near the 12 European model as of early Friday, which is day 7. Now, it's going to happen. Whatever's going to happen will happen on Friday if it looks like anything is going to, and I'm expecting probably that's next Friday, the 25th. If the National Hurricane Center thinks something may be going on, we should probably be hearing something and something showing up on the National Hurricane weather maps, possibly anywhere from, I'd say, Sunday through Tuesday of this coming week, okay? Now, what else is going on with it? It seems that the Canadian model has strayed faster with a track farther west, and it may take a while for the guidance clustering to improve significantly for this feature. That's one thing I've noticed within all the models is the clustering. It just can't seem to do it, and that's because of the winds, and I'll show you that. Now, in the time frame of the forecast, it's transitioned to half of the weight with the European mean, with remaining input spread among the GEFS and the European and Canadian model. Now, the GEFS mean compared favorably to the other solutions over the western states and eastern Pacific, but was likely too quick to lower pressure over the eastern Gulf and Florida Peninsula. So I think, you know, the GEFS model, don't worry about it right now. We need to concentrate more on the GEFS and the European model. Now, what you're looking at now, and I'll scroll it down in just a moment, but I want to explain something right quickly. This is the GEFS FV3 model. Now, it's an experimental model at this time, okay? And it's still being tested by the NCEP models, so that's why I don't put a lot of faith into this. And as you can see right here, you can see that it was coming up in here. We'll move it along just a little bit. I just wanted to show you that on this model, when I was speaking a while ago about what was going on, remember it said this model pushed it further to the west, and there it is, but I really don't think that's what's going to happen. Now, if you want to follow the GEFS model and get very good pictures, Vent Sky is a good site to follow for that. You can see everything plainly. This is only for the GFS model, okay? We will check out the European model in just a few moments. But this is on the 25th. Nothing's going to happen. You can see it's down here around Cuba. It has to go up over part some of the mountain range, so that's going to take a little bit of oomph out of it. This is just for rain right in here. On the 25th, around 8, we'll move up to 11 p.m. and we'll see what it's looking like right off of the coast, north southern tip of Florida, the Keys. It's got lots of rain in it, as you can see, and almost 3 inches of rain in places. Almost 4 inches of rain down around Miami. 3.5 as it's moving along. How about the wind? We need to know what the wind is looking like. This would be sustained winds, not too bad at all. Remember, it has to be 39 miles per hour sustained winds to be a tropical storm. Well, it is right there. It's trying. It's trying, people. This is around 11 p.m. on the 25th, 1 week from today. It looks like it could turn into, according to the GFS model, into a tropical storm. At this point, does it have any wind gusts to it that is higher? Let's check that out right quick. And we will see what's happening. Yes, 49 miles per hour, 55 miles per hour. That's why I'm giving this thing a 45 to 50% chance. I think it could turn into something, okay? Despite what all of the formal weather jargon and weathermen are saying, I think this could happen. Of course, it's not wrote in stone. It might not happen. These things change. And I'll show you something about the current path it's taking. What we really have to watch is the wind shear. But let's move on up now to the 26th. If we can get there right quickly, here we go. See how it spun out? I'm going to show you why it does that in just a moment. But this is rain in it. The rain bands, once again, still aren't really in good formation, but they're trying to get there real fast as it's off the coast of Florida, a little of Alabama and Georgia, not Alabama, but Georgia and South Carolina, excuse me there. Okay, this is rain. What's the wind doing now? Regular sustained winds on Saturday, the 26th. This is what they're looking like. Okay, not too bad in Florida. The winds aren't bad, bad at all. Offshore, though, look at there. And this is going to be circulating, bringing in water as it moves around. So keep that in mind, okay? Keep that in mind. We'll go back to the precipitation. And we will go to Sunday, the 27th. And where will it be? Boom! It shoots it way off the coast, okay? This is at 8 p.m., but let's go back Sunday to around 2 a.m. in the morning, if it will get there. Come on. Okay, now we've got it right for a change. Does your computer ever do what it wants to sometimes? I've got so many things open, mine don't know what to do. But this is Sunday the 27th, as you can see right in here. What's going on? Okay, on the 27th, this is the center of circulation right in here. Doesn't look too impressive. It does have some rain in it, though. Still got some rain. These bands are starting to fall apart some, but they're still going all the way down through Cuba. Large stream of tropical moist air. It's going to be coming in down from Florida all the way up to the mid-Atlantic. And at this time, we'll move up to around 8 a.m. on Sunday. Moving up, you can see what's happening. What about winds? That's important. We need to check out the wind to see if it does have tropical storm characteristics. This is sustained winds. Some of the winds offshore are still tropical storm. These are sustained winds now. Right in the center, it's hardly nothing. It's like 7 miles per hour. It never is anything. But right offshore, let's see if we see any that would be coming in that's 39 miles per hour. Looks like, according to the GFS model, not around Florida. What about around South Carolina? Yes, some of these winds will be tropical storm force right offshore. So that's going to be pushing in a lot of water no matter what happens. So, what about wind gust at this point? We'll see what happens when it brings up the gust. What are the gusts coming in down around South Carolina, North Carolina border? They are around 47, 45 up to 50 miles per hour. Still down Florida and South Carolina, you could possibly have some come on shore from about 40 to 43 miles per hour. So that's what the GFS is looking like through Sunday, the 22nd or 27th. Now, on Friday, May 25th, when we should see something one way or the other start to brew a little bit, these are the steering currents, okay, at the 500 millibar height. All right, right in here, you can see how it's moving up. It's kind of captured in between these two waves. Once it gets past this wave, it moves on up. Let's move it up some, just a hair. It will come right back in a second. Here we go, still trapped. We'll move up to around 198 hours. You see what's going on. This one eventually moves out. I'm not going to go through the whole thing because this is very, very long anyway. But this one escapes and it brings it closer up into this area. Now let's right quickly check out the European model. This is on Friday, the 25th, around 11 a.m. There's some more showers right down below, but the clusters are very far apart. Once again, that's why I'm giving it a 45 to 50% chance at this time when it first starts out, okay? This is the rain in it. We'll check all the rain out. Let's see about the wind right quick, what the winds are looking like. And they're not looking too bad. This is the sustained winds that will be coming in from it. We'll see if it will put it up 29 miles per hour. Not a tropical depression at this time with those sustained winds anywhere. And that was one of the highest places. So, what shall we do? Let's just move it along now with the wind. We'll move up to around 10 p.m. Friday night. We can see how the wind is getting better organized in it as it gets closer to the coast. So let's see what the winds are looking like from the European model. Still not tropical storm sustained winds at 30 miles per hour. So we'll go up to Saturday. This is around 9 a.m. in the morning. Winds are coming on shore now. Let's blow this up just a little bit if we can to see where we might have an idea where some of these higher sustained winds are coming in. There's Port St. Lucie right there, in between there and right around in here. What are these sustained winds at their highest point? 28, still not a tropical depression. However, when you get down around Nassau and Marsh Harbor, they are a little higher at this point. As you write in here. Now we're up to around 9 p.m. on the 26th Saturday. You can see that the center is very weak. It's moved offshore to some degree now. The winds are very clustered up together, though. We'll move it on up to as far as we can go with the winds. This will be around 7 p.m. on Sunday, the 27th. Now, things are looking a little different. That little dot you see, that's about where I live. I'm a little further out in the water, but that's about where I live right there. What are the sustained winds that will be pushing water up around my house at this time? Let's see what they're looking like. Well, 42 miles per hour. So that is tropical storm, remember? 39 is tropical storm sustained. These are winds of 42 offshore that's going to be bringing this in. Maybe it could possibly turn into one. I don't think so. I think it's going to just be a really bad low system, or it could be a very low end tropical storm at this point. We'll have to wait and see. So far as wind gust, yes, they are up there. This thing will be packing wind gust of 63 miles per hour. That's only, I don't know what, maybe 8 miles from being a Category 1 hurricane. But this is wind gust. This is what we need to look at, people, and consider, because this is where the flooding comes in. When all of this water gets banked up and pushed in, this goes all the way down. And you folks in South Carolina, probably Saturday, you're going to have the same problem. Now, none of this is wrote in stone again. It can change at any time. This is just what it's looking like to me at this time. We will go back to around Saturday at 10 a.m. Check out the precipitation in this. As you see, it's down around Florida, moving up towards St. Lucie and on up in this area with a lot of it out in the water. So let's just continue and go to Saturday around 9 p.m. The center, of course, is right here over Florida. Not really bad, 29.67. Nothing is tightly compacted at this time. Once again, I think it will be a very strong low pressure system. I could be wrong, or a very low tropical storm with a lot of things that go along with a tropical storm. Then it's moving on up, as you can see. Now it's off of the Georgia coast altogether. This is Sunday at 5, and we'll move it up as far as we can go. And here we go. This is Sunday around 7 p.m. on the 27th, as the low is here, and it is moving up towards our area. So with all of that said and done, we'll have to wait and see what happens. It's kind of up in the air right now, still a little ways out to really tell anything. But this is what I think about it, what I've told you this morning. I will not make a tropical update every day. I'll do one every 2 or 3 days as I think I see things and want to make you aware of things. But I will say this, people from North Carolina all the way down to Florida, please have your hurricane kits fixed and have a plan. It's what, 12, 13 days, I haven't counted them up, not far away from actual hurricane season starting. So please, please keep this in mind. Go ahead and get it done. Thank you so much for watching. If you're into the weather like I am, and you like to know what's going on and be prepared for things, whether they happen or whether they don't, it's better to be prepared than not, of course. Please subscribe, click the bell, and make sure you get all of the latest in weather news, forecast, alerts, and warnings. Thank you guys so much for everything you do for me. I love you all. With this said and done, I'll make another update as this system gets closer. Peace, love, and kindness to all.